Hello, I'm Maria, and today I'm going to show you how to add pagination manually or with plugins. Adjusting your site's pagination can help you create a more user-friendly, easy navigable website. However, many WordPress themes don't offer detailed pagination options, which means you're limited in the changes that you can make. Thankfully, there are some easy ways to adjust WordPress pagination. In this video, we will cover everything that you need to know about WordPress pagination. But before we get too far, I want to let you know that there will be links to more resources in the video's description. And remember, subscribe and ring that bell to get notifications for future helpful content. Now, on to controlling WordPress pagination manually. Let's talk about the built-in options for working with pagination, using the 2021 theme as an example. By default, WordPress will show 10 posts per page. So if you have 25 posts, you would have 3 total pages. The first 2 pages should show 10 posts each, and the last page would show the remaining 5 posts. If you want to adjust the number, you can go to Settings, then Reading, and edit the blog pages Show as Most Value. So far, we've mainly focused on breaking your blog listing page into multiple pages. However, WordPress also lets you divide individual posts or pages into various pages, which might be helpful in some situations. If you're using the WordPress block editor, aka Gutenberg, you can choose where to add page breaks using the page break block. If you're using the classic Tiny MCE editor, you can choose where to add page breaks using one of two methods. One, you can place your mouse cursor where you want to add the page break in the visual tab of the editor. Then, use the following keyboard shortcut, Alt plus Shift plus P. Or, you can manually place the page break by pasting the following snippet into the text tab of the editor. If you're not a very technical person, this method probably isn't for you. You might want to skip ahead to the pagination plugins. However, if you feel comfortable making minor code tweaks to your site, you can adjust your theme's pagination using PHP and CSS. Because you'll be editing your theme's template files, you must use a WordPress child theme. Otherwise, your changes will get overwritten the next time you update your theme. We also recommend backing up your site before making any changes. If you want to add pagination to any WordPress theme manually, you can use the Posts Pagination function. For example, the following snippet. You would add this snippet directly to your child theme's template files where you want the pagination to appear. We've left the default 2021 pagination and added our own pagination using the code snippet to see the difference. The page 1 pagination is the theme's default, and the 1, 2, 3 pagination comes from our custom code. Here's what that looks like in the code. You can see the original pagination function and our custom pagination. You'd want to replace the existing pagination function with your custom function on a live WordPress site. Warning, we recommend doing it on a staging site first. This is just an example. You might need to edit multiple files depending on your theme. You might find it more convenient to connect to your server via an FTP client and use a dedicated PHP editor to edit your theme files. To adjust the style of your theme's pagination, you'll need to add some custom CSS. If you want more control over your site's pagination, you might prefer using a WordPress pagination plugin. Here are 7 of the top options available. Active on over 700,000 sites, WP-PageNavi is the most popular WordPress pagination plugin by a good margin. It's also 100% free, which helps explain its popularity. It gives you a simple settings area where you can control the behavior of your site's pagination. You can adjust the text, how many page numbers to show, and more. If you want more control over the design of your pagination, you can also consider the third-party styles for WP-PageNavi add-on plugin. Because WP-PageNavi is so popular, some WordPress themes offer built-in support for the plugin. If your theme does, all you need to do is activate the plugin, configure its settings, and you're good to go. You can access the settings by going to Settings and then Page Navi. However, if your theme doesn't include built-in support, you'll need to manually edit your theme's template files to get the plugin working, which can be a little complicated if you're not a very technical person. You need to find the default code your theme uses for pagination and replace it with WP-PageNavi's custom code snippet. The developer explains how to do this on the plugin's WordPress.org page. WP-Paginate is another popular plugin for setting up custom pagination on your WordPress site. In addition to helping you paginate your posts, you can also use the plugin to add custom pagination to your comments sections, which can help you speed up your comments. Unlike the WP-PageNavi plugin, you do not need to edit your theme template files directly, which might make this a better option if you're not a technical person. For more advanced users, you still have the option of using PHP to place the pagination in your theme's template files manually. With the plugin, you'll be able to customize all aspects of pagination, including labels and buttons, placement, and how many navigation items to display. To configure the plugin, you can go to Settings, then WP-Paginate to control the plugin settings. If you want to display the plugin's pagination without editing your theme's template files, you'll want to make the following selections in the location and position settings. Check the Everywhere box to display your new pagination everywhere pagination is needed. Set the position dropdown equal to below the content. Next, check the Hide Standard Pagination box to hide your theme's existing pagination. Pagination by BestWebSoft is another pagination plugin that lets you add a new pagination system to your site without needing to edit your theme's template files. However, like the WP-Paginate plugin, you still have the option to edit your theme's template files if you want more control over placement. Via the plugin settings, you'll be able to easily adjust the location, style, and behavior of your pagination. To configure the plugin, go to the New Pagination tab in your dashboard. The plugin's default settings will automatically hide your theme's existing pagination and replace it with the custom pagination from the plugin. All you need to do is configure the settings for the style and behavior of your new pagination. Ajax Load More lets you create buttons that load more content without forcing the user to load a new page. It gives you several options for controlling pagination, including traditional pagination and some unique twists. If you're willing to purchase some premium add-ons, you can add actual pagination buttons. When users move to a new page, they won't perceive the page as reloading, but the URL will change, which is good for SEO. Ajax Load More lets you replace your pagination with a Load More button with the free version. Instead of adding pagination links that visitors can use to navigate to a different page, Ajax Load More lets you add a Load More button to display more posts without reloading the page. Instead of adding pagination to your existing post list, the Ajax Load More plugin works by creating a new post list that includes your desired settings. To set this up, you'll use the Ajax Load More area in your WordPress dashboard. If you want to set up traditional pagination, make sure to purchase and install the Paging add-on. The Alphabetic Pagination plugin helps you implement a different type of pagination on your site, an A to Z listing. Rather than paginating by numbers and ordering posts by their publish dates, Alphabetic Pagination lets you create a pagination option for each letter of the alphabet. Then, if a user clicks on a specific letter, they'll see all the content pieces that start with that letter. To use the plugin, head to Settings and then Alphabetic Pagination to configure its settings. In the General tab of the plugin settings, you can configure where to display your alphabetic pagination. Using the auto implementation is the simplest option. However, you can manually place your alphabetic pagination using the shortcodes or PHP function in the shortcodes tab. Once you've configured the placement, you can control the design of your alphabetic pagination from the styling tab. WP Show Posts is a helpful plugin that lets you create your posts lists complete with custom pagination. That's the key detail. You're not adding pagination to your existing blog post list. Instead, you're creating a new blog post list that includes your own pagination settings. The plugin also includes a flexible query builder so that you can choose exactly which posts to show, and therefore which posts you want to paginate. Once you activate the plugin, you can go to WP Show Posts, then Add New, to create a new post list. We recommend exploring all of the settings to control what content to display. In setting up pagination, check the pagination box in the Posts tab and set the number of posts per page. Once you've set everything up, you can add your post list using its short code or PHP function. As the name suggests, Pagination Styler for WooCommerce is a pagination plugin specifically for WooCommerce stores. It gives you many new options for controlling your store's product pagination positioning and style. You can choose from completely different layouts, such as vertical pagination instead of the traditional horizontal pagination. Pagination Styler for WooCommerce works by replacing your existing WooCommerce pagination with the plugin's pagination. To configure the plugin settings, you can go to BRocket, then Pagination Styler in your WordPress dashboard. Kinsta's WordPress hosting can speed up your website by up to 200%, and you'll get 24/7 support from our expert WordPress engineers. We offer 2 months free with any annual plan, a 30-day money-back guarantee, and unlimited free basic migrations from any host. Head over to kinsta.com/plans to get started. Thank you so much for watching. If you found this video helpful, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell for more tutorials, explainers, and helpful content like this.